Hey, what's up? It's Ake here. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'd like to talk about why I want to extend Markdown. So I've been running Inkjob, which is a Markdown note taking app, and I've decided to never implement proprietary Markdown extensions, as that's the philosophy of the app. So the strength of Markdown, specifically GitHub flavored Markdown, lies in its status as a widely used, loosely standardized document format in the software industry. If I were to add app-specific syntax, the notes you write would instantly lose compatibility with other Markdown tools. You might think adding proprietary syntax could enable more convenient features. And indeed, Markdown isn't the perfect format, so there are cases where extensions seem necessary, like the lack of standardized way to specify image sizes, for example. And still, I prioritized the portability of notes above all else. Behind this choice lies a philosophy rooted in Zen. So as you may know, Japanese culture tends to blend with, adapt to, and coexist with its surroundings rather than confront them. This is evident in concepts like Shake, a borrowed scenery, in Windows, Kare-sansi, it's a dry landscape gardens, and the asymmetry of architecture, and the simplicity of tea rooms, and the aesthetics of wabi-sabi. It's one of the minimalism philosophy. So let me explain with the example of the subtractive brush technique, which is called genpitsu in painting. So this method involves using minimal brush strokes to depict forms on silk or paper. So Zen painters have used this technique to express psychological landscapes. For example, take Wagtail on a Lotus by Moke. Yeah, so this picture drawn by Moke. Yes, so a solitary bird perches on a withered branch. And as you can see, not a single unnecessary line or shadow is drawn. Yet it fully conveys the desolate feeling of autumn. In this way, the canvas's empty space is fully utilized, with only the bare minimum of elements added. The Eastern perspective sees life from within, not from the outside. This contrasts with Western art, which often expresses transcendence over harsh nature through gorgeous and rich magnificence. So Inkjob embodies this Zen spirit, seeking harmony and collaboration with Markdown and its surrounding ecosystem with tools and platforms. I want the notes you write in Inkjob to flow outward and return, allowing your ideas and sensibilities to expand and be refined. I aim to support this life cycle. So in fact, from a business perspective, introducing proprietary syntax might allow me to unlock users in. Vendor locking, which could be advantageous in the note app market. However, looking at other apps that have adopted proprietary syntax, it's clear that this often leads to complexity, difficulty in learning, or struggles with the syntax conversion. So for an indie developer like me, half-hearted extensions do more harm than good. So I think that sticking to compatibility and harmonizing with the Markdown ecosystem ultimately benefits the app. So as a result, it's a win for the app creator, the users, and ecosystem. So this is a concept known in Japan as Sanpo Yoshi, three-way satisfaction. From the philosophy of Omi Shounin. So for these reasons, Inkjob has not and will not extend Markdown. Okay, so I promise. So feel free to take your tech notes with confidence. That's the philosophy of Inkjob. Yes. So I recently released the Inkjob version 6 Canary, and it's been Canary.3, revision 3, and I released this 2 days ago, and which supports highlighting support with HTML mark tag. So it allows you to highlight your notes in Markdown. So as you can see, so you can insert, you can use HTML mark tag to highlight like this. So the editor detects this mark tag and highlights it like this. So this is very useful if you have a lot of reading notes. So Inkjob supports Kindle Highlights with the Chrome extension and the Firefox extension. So this is a perfect combination for your reading notes. Yes. So I didn't extend Markdown, okay? As I talked, the philosophy of Inkjob. So there's no breaking changes. So it just works everywhere. And also, I've added this navigation and layout buttons. And then you can switch view mode from these buttons. So these buttons are here in the current version 5, but it is hidden by default, so it is not clear for the new users to understand how to check how to toggle the view mode. So I decided to move these buttons to the header bar. Also, in the Canary 2, it finally supports find in preview, so you can find directory, start searching text, yeah, like this. So it works flawlessly. Yeah, it's cool. I love it. And also, it supports strike through for the finished task items. Yes, and also it supports open URL tooltip, so you can open the link by clicking this tooltip, so it's very useful. You don't have to switch to the preview mode. Yeah, that's it. And I'd like to say thank you to the guys who reported issues. So thank you, Christopher Navas and Lucas, Thank you so much. And Bandit, and Yuichiro Matsumoto-san. And yeah, also for Revision 3, thank you for reporting bugs, Lucas. Yeah, Lucas reported a lot of issues. Thank you so much. And JN and Zurab and the Rapid Ostrich and Marco. Thank you so much. So it's now much more stable now. Please enjoy the new version. And I'm going to work on these features like update syntax to your themes and the theme preview, notebook icons, sidebar improvements, and on and on. Yeah, and I can't wait to implement these new features. It's so exciting. Yeah, I'm enjoying implementing these features. Yeah, it's so fun. And getting feedback and fixing bugs, this cycle. I'm pretty much enjoying this cycle. Yeah, so thank you for watching. So that's it. Yeah, so let's enjoy building the great note-taking app. Yeah, so that's it. Thank you for watching. Have a productive day.